In this video, we learn what role certificates play in TLS connections, what a certificate store is, and what does a certificate authority do. So let's start with an example. Raman has come to a new city and he doesn't know anything or anyone here. He's a busy man, so he wants to hire a cook. But he's scared to hire a complete stranger. Not only is he unaware of their cooking skills, he recently saw the movie Parasite and that has made him paranoid. He is now aware of the other dangers as well. That's when Raman learns that there are some institutes that teach cooking as a skill. So then he thinks, any graduates from these institutes would be good and hopefully professional cooks. So he gets an idea. He does some research and makes a list of all the good cooking institutes. After this, he adds one major criteria for his future cook. This person must be from one of these institutes and they must have a certificate with them to prove it. Luckily, he finds just the cook he's looking for. So let's see what happened here. Raman, a complete stranger, was able to establish trust with another complete stranger using a common trustworthy institute. When we compare our example to a TLS connection, we see that Raman is the client. This is the end user connecting to the server. The cook is the server and the institutes are the certificate authority or the CA. It is the server's job to ensure that the client trusts them. They do this using a certificate obtained from the CA. A list of these CAs is stored in a certificate store on the client. This is usually stored in the operating system, but in the case of Firefox, it's in the browser itself. All of this is dependent on the certificate authority, as they are the ones who create and supply certificates for the servers. And that is why the trustworthiness of the CA is paramount. If the CA messes up, then the entire system breaks down. And that is why it is essential that the CA be a trusted authority. Now that we know what a certificate authority is, let's talk about intermediate certificate authorities. What are these? A trusted CA may delegate the job of giving certificates to other authorities. Certificates from these authorities remain trusted as long as they are trusted by the main or the root CA. These authorities can in turn delegate to other authorities, who can then delegate to others, and so on. As long as the bottommost authority can show a clear connection to the root CA, the certificate is still trusted. This connection to the topmost CA or the root CA is called the chain of trust. If at any point the chain breaks, the trust is gone. This is the digital equivalent of the phrase, a friend of a friend is my friend. Now let's see this in action. We look at the little lock on Wikipedia's site indicating that it's a secure HTTPS connection. This connection is verified by a company called DigiCert. When we view the certificate, we see that it is verified by an intermediate CA, DigiCert SHA High Assurance Server CA, which is in turn verified by the main root CA, DigiCert High Assurance EV Root CA. Now we look at the list of authorities that the Firefox browser trusts, which is also known as Firefox's certificate store, and we see that the main root CA is present. That's all we had for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.